Now let's get into the ask that you have to do on your trailer for Indiegogo or any crowdfunding site. The most important thing to remember is that this came out of my book, my first edition of The Art of Film Funding. People give money to people, not to films. So who are you? Why do you want this money? What do you intend to do with it? What's your deadline? How important is it? Show me your heart. You have to really open up, be honest, sincere, and touch me. This is the key to getting your money. And you have to make that ask in the first 45 seconds. The film should be no longer than 4 minutes. People never watch the end. You may find 80% do not watch the end of it. And we've always said that because I'm a grantor. We have a film grant from the Hart Productions. And I know that to get judges to watch the entire trailer is sometimes the hardest part because they watch maybe 2 minutes and say, that's it, I've got the story. But that's not enough. But they will do that on Kickstarter and on Indiegogo. And we know because we have statistics. Indiegogo has put together really good statistics for you and analysis. And you want to check out right under where you launch your program. There's a heart. And that is an important thing for you to research and find out how that works because you want people to refer your film to their friends. And when they do, you get to hear about it. You know they referred you and you get to give them extra little gifts. Okay, back to the trailer. Your 4-minute trailer should start off with you, the filmmaker, talking. Then if you want to cut into some scenes from your film and show us what the subject is about in your film, go right ahead. But know that you're probably never going to watch all of it. Put the most important stuff up front and fast. And if you want people to help you, you can get them too. There are many things that you need besides just money. Donations and free goods, lots of things. You have got to give perks. That's what's in it for me, again. We say that for everything you ask for, you may start with a $25 donation, then $50, $100, $300, $1,000, etc. You want to have a donation, you want to have a gift to go for that donation, and tie it into your film. For example, Jill Ann Spitzmiller did her film on about a Shakespearean play and a group of actors, and she tied her donations in with names of Shakespeare's plays. And so make it all fit together. And where do you get your donations? Well, you might go to people in your neighborhood or people that you know in the film industry and see who has something they can donate. And don't forget your own talents. You're a cinematographer, you're a producer, director, and you have an editor on your crew. You might take someone's interview and give it to them for $400, $500 is not unrealistic for an hour interview. You might, if you're doing something about, let's say these friends of mine were doing a film about India, and the mother and brother of the filmmaker were good cooks, so they offered to cook dinner and entertain for $500, bring it to them for 12 people. That's fun. Think of your talents and what you can do, and don't be afraid to go for the big money. Jill Ann Spitzmiller was going to go back east to shoot her film. So she put her house online for $7,500 so you could have it for 1 month. And would you believe that someone who never met her, does not know her personally, paid her the $7,500? This is so much fun. This is what crowdfunding is all about. It's doing it with others. So don't be afraid to put big numbers on there. And what can you give away? You can give away an executive producer credit for enough money. Also, associate producer credits. It's all yours. Do creative things to get your money. So what's next? You've got the ask video. Now, you have to do something in writing to go on your website. And if you go to our website, I'm sorry, on your crowdfunding page, you have to put something in writing and hopefully you'll create a very in-depth concept about your film. FromTheHartProductions.com has a section called Financing Information. go online, check it out. It's on the left-hand side, and you will find tons of information, lists of grantors and places to go for money. You'll find my third chapter of how to create a film proposal, and that's what you want to read so you know what to put. It can help you write your proposal to go online. So the next thing is people. Build up your newsletter list so that you've got at least 500, 1,000 people on there. And then consider a newsletter company that you can find online. They're pretty cheap. You can find one for $30, $40 a month. You're definitely going to need it. And I recommend that you do a lot of pre-production before you ever start, and before you launch. Get your pre-production set up. Get your website working. Get your Facebook page up. And definitely join a newsletter company. Get all of your names loaded. And maybe even create 3 newsletters ahead of time so that when you launch your campaign, you'll be very busy answering emails and thanking people for their donations. One woman was really successful when she sat down before she launched and she did 200 handwritten requests to everyone in her database, and it was astounding the amount of money she got back from these people because it was personally written, heartfelt, and it paid off. So good luck with your crowdfunding, and check us out online. If you need more information, there's a ton of it on fromtheheartproductions.com. Thank you.